Now, these protests are receiving international coverage, becoming one of the most notable in Hawaii's history. Sam Spangler joins us now with a look into what has made the demonstrations gain momentum. Sam?
Lauren, Hawaii has a strong history of civilians standing up for what they believe. And according to UH's political science chair, Noelani Goodyear Ka'opua, the current TMT protests hold similarities to another land-based protest.
We can go back to, for example, the Protect Kaho'olawe Ohana and their stopping of the bombing of Kaho'olawe from the 1970s through to the return of the island, which similarly was driven solely by aloha aina.
What the Kaho'olawe advocates didn't have at their fingertips was the ability to unite with social media, changing the opportunity to organize.
You know, this is a new generation of activists and people who are really skilled in being able to utilize the media at their fingertips to be able to tell their own stories.
It's allowed the protest to include multiple United States cities and an international following.
It's really a worldwide issue, and I think this issue resonates with many, many indigenous peoples who are protecting sacred places and peoples in general who are protecting important natural and cultural resources.
According to Professor Goodyear Ka'opua, the unison seen between protests on separate islands has been what has driven the cause's success.
Right, and we saw that in 2015, and we're seeing that again now, that this is not just localized to Hawaii Island, but that there were actions of support on Maui, on Oahu, and that sense of unity, of connection and solidarity across the channels between our islands is really a large part of what is making this movement so successful.
Now, Professor Goodyear Ka'opua also said that the history of Hawaiian protests often gain power if they are held over the protection of land. Lauren, we'll send it back to you.